research is discriminating was the project of advancing our project. It is an H2020 project. Its name is Active. Okay. It's the complete name of our project is Active University. That is because the target of the project is represented by high school students applying to university. And the project is about the dropout taxon, because a lot of students at good university cannot pass the first year on the trial in some way. So our project is to help them. And I put here the list of all partners because I think that is important, because yeah, Open University is a half of the world, but it's also the other. And there are lots of partners everywhere, and last but not least, there is also China, that is a big reality. So, most of countries, there are two partners. One partner is a technological one, like GAM, you know, that is about the global in Italy, and an academic one to support from a pedagogical point of view. Our key objective, as I saw for you before, is to bridge the gap between the second and the third world. To the university. And we should use the digital ecosystem that we are hoping to create to support them. To support them especially in to have the digital competences they need to go on to the university. So our project is based on three aspects, that is ecosystem, is key competences, and last but not least, the learning path and the kind of interaction that there is between students and the platform itself. We call ecosystem all this, so it's quite a complicated figure. So it's also called NGDLP, that stands for New Generation Digital Learning Environment, or Open Garden, because it's an opposite to the idea of world garden. For example, you know, Moodle's class, for example, you go inside, you stay inside. But our idea is to create something that is open to everyone. Once you are inside, you can go everywhere inside. So the characteristic is that users can access the whole system with a single sign-on. And they can find inside this ecosystem a lot of tools and sub-environments that can serve for them. For teachers in realizing effective teaching methodology to acquire skills, and for students to find out something interesting for them. Then the system includes also the XAPI, compliance subsystem, to support the collection and analysis of assessment data. And from our point of view, this aspect of the XAPI is quite important. So, as I said before, our system will support the skills, students and the acquisition of new skills. What kind of skills? So we did a survey, because we had to work with schools, together with schools. So we looked in literature what kind of skills, soft skills, what kind of digital competences students need for the university. So we asked to university teachers what they think that students lack when they arrive at the university. And after we asked to high school teachers what do you think that your students need to supply to university. The results were there were some differences between them, especially about the skills. For example, in blue, you can see the school teachers' answers, and in red, you can see the university teachers' task. So there are big differences, especially about critical thinking, also autonomy. Yes. At the end, we found out that the four skills that that's needed are communication and collaboration, critical thinking and problem solving, media and technology literacy, and self-direction. About the methodology to reach these competencies, teachers were more, university teachers and school teachers agreed more. And they, again, there are five strategies: project-based learning, test-based learning, scenario-based learning, good classroom, and experiential learning. So our ecosystem supports these, all these competencies of this teaching strategy. And the kind of interaction that we think that our system supports that students and teachers will face when they use the ecosystem is based on four steps. The first one is about the soft skills I listed before. The second one is about teaching methodology that I listed before. The third one is about technology tools, so the ecosystem itself. And the last, there are digital competencies that the students will acquire, I can say, naturally through this path. It's important to underline that digital competencies and soft skills are very similar, but I would say that for the past. So now we are in the middle of the project, because this project started in January 2017, and we began at the beginning there was nothing, so we created a platform, and in the last year we are involving schools to test the system and to improve the system itself. Because the idea is to test, to receive feedback, to change it, to improve it, and to collect data in order to improve it, direct data, asking teachers and students about the experience, and indirect data using the API or other learning analytics. And our challenge now is to use to cross inverse data with the data we are going to collect. Now we are in the middle of the first pilot cycle, it's called pilot cycle, and we will do another second cycle within the end of the project. The first module, you can see there, is a teacher's training, I can say. So teachers learn professional development course for more than teacher training about the environment itself, about the competences they need to teach, and about the teaching strategy. The second module is a pilot itself, so teachers will apply what they learn in class. The third one is to receive feedback, and the fourth one is to write something, to kind of report, to share with everyone. And after, recommend to improve the platform, to improve the start journey system, and so on. Practically speaking, this is what we have. So there are a home page, there are a Moodle system, and after, under there is a list of all other tools that you have. And you can see a red circle that is about learning analytics, because we think that it's very important to give students and teachers a feedback immediately. I mean, not every 4 years, not at the end of the whole period or at the end of the year, but during the period. So we think that give learning analytics immediately, it's very important. And the basic, the core of this learning analytics, I can say, the innovation, is this XLPI. If someone of you know about XLPI, I'm sorry, because I'm going to explain it. Basically speaking, the XFBI is a quite new technology that follows users in their activities and after send a feedback to a learning record store. It means that the students that, for example, do a research, and use a smartphone to look for something. Normally speaking, a teacher doesn't know if they what they do, how students reach an information. But it can be important because if a student just go to Wikipedia, copy the page, paste the page, it's very different if students go to Wikipedia and go to other pages and collect information and get something completely different. So it can be very important. Okay, basically speaking, the XAPI do that. So collect information, so tracking some users' activities, and giving them the control of their own data because students own data. That's important from the privacy point of view. Another important point that is not listed here is that XAPI don't give just numbers, but give action. So there's a subject, student's smartphone. What to do? So for example, look for, where, and when. This kind of information. This kind of information are flexible ones, so we can decide which kind of information to collect. And the important point is that in this way we can track, we can put informal education to communicate with formal education because this is an important point. In fact, in our system that is in the middle, we plan to work with three aspects. So we have formal education, non-formal education, and informal education. Okay. So the formal education is normal school. Informal education is go to Wikipedia, for example, sort of thing. And non-formal education is, for example, if you go to a British school or some kind of private school, that is not formal because it's not. But anyway, it's a kind of school. So it's important to work all together because students use all of this kind of education in the same time. And normally speaking, teachers don't know and schools don't know what to do outside school. So it's important to know them because it can give a more picture of students' education. And this is very important about the digital competences because most of the competences that actual students achieve is outside school. For example, smartphones. They use smartphones, so we said don't use smartphones at school or some kind of thing. But maybe it's important because of using smartphones and digital competences. And also it's important because in February, the digital competence agency, not this, but anyway, the European Union published a digital competences in education, and listed a list of five digital competences that students have to reach. So, this information, media literacy, digital communication and collaboration, digital content creation, responsible use, and digital problem solving. Here there is a direct candy figure that is for teachers. So from the European Union point of view, teachers have to have professional engagement, digital resources, teaching, learning, assessment, and problem learners. And in the right 6 points, there is a facilitating the learners' digital competences. The learning competences is the 5-1. That are almost the same of us, of our sort of sales skills that we selected as up to. So, what up to system can collect information about learners, learning, and learning outcome. So our idea is that we can complement in some way the advanced data in order to test hypotheses. For example, correlation between language literacy and digital competences in the data. And that, of course, is just a starting point. Okay. So data that after you can collect is the results of assessment and data of interaction and also data on work and education, application of digital media. And also after, because the idea is that students have to create something, to be active, that's important. So, to conclude, XAPI transforms the active platform in a big data source, big data keyboard now in today's world, about students and classes. So it can be decisive in helping assessment process today. After you intend to be open to new agreement between education stakeholders and formal education institutions. The basic idea is to create a kind of trust relationship between students, teachers, and institutions. So students accept to share their data with teachers in the school institution. In exchange, they receive a continuous help. And just to say again about the connection between Vatsi and our idea, that some way Vatsi take a picture every time, maybe 3 or 4 years, depending. But our idea is to create a movie, I can say, during one time. So maybe we can share and compare data to have some 3D picture.